Hi friend, welcome to Zero Entire. Today we are going to discuss remaining part of the magnetic method of exploration. So in this lesson we are going to discuss field procedure of magnetic method. After taking readings, how data can be redacted by applying different technique. Then removing regional effects from the magnetic anomaly map. Then interpretation and last part applications. These are the aspects I am going to discuss in this lesson. So the first part of the magnetic which has already you have seen, but if you want to see again, so go on my cards and click there, you can see the first part of the magnetic method of exploration. So let's we start the lesson. The field procedure is depend on the objectives of that particular surveying, the map of that particular area, geological map, traverse line planning, their spacing and stations, instrument selection and precautions. So on the basis of this, we have to do field procedure. So first, that is the objectives of this surveying. So the magnetometer surveying depends upon its objectives. So whether it is connected with the locations of the deposits of the mineral, or it is related to the structures or mining purpose. So on the basis of that, we have to change our surveying procedure. Once our objectives is fixed, then we have to go the geological map of that particular area. If we have geological map of that area, so it is easy to surveying. So the next aspect, that is the traverse line planning. So the traverse lines are planned on topographic map and the lines are laid out marking different points on the ground. So it is better to study the results obtained on one of two lines at first and then cover the whole area by systematic grid of lines. The spacing of the lines and the station intervals may be selected keeping in view of the probable depth and width of the target and the details of the survey required. Then instrument selection. In instrument selection, the most common instrument used for the magnetic surveying, so that is the seismic type magnetometer, and the field procedure depends on the particular instruments. Then there are some, we have to take some precautions. So during carrying out the instruments or magnetometer, so the magnet system should not be transported over long distances. So while it is kept on the agate bearings in the instruments, even though it is clamped down and not free to oscillate, the mechanical jerks can blunt the knife edge or otherwise damage the bearings. So the magnet system should always be transported separately in the container box, which is specially provided with suitable grooves and soft paddings. So once we have transported the equipment, then before setting up the instruments, the observation point or the operator should make sure that watches and other iron and steel objects are kept away some distances. So the tripod stand should be placed so that the center point is directly above the station. If the heat of the sun is too severe, it is better to shield the instrument in operation with non-magnetic umbrella. The instrument is set up on the tripod and leveled. In the case of vertical force magnetometer, the instrument is set at right angles to the magnetic meridian, and at least two readings are taken for each setting, with the north pole of the system facing east and west respectively. So the rail tracks, iron fences, power lines, building bridges with steel girders, etc. near the station of the measurement will differentiate or give wrong readings, and the interferences by such sources should be avoided. So these are the precautions we have to take during the field procedure of this magnetic survey. Next, that is the reduction of data. So reduction of data, when we taking all the readings, so there should be some reduction of data is required. So the magnetometer readings obtained in the field are converted into the magnetic intensities. And generally it is in gammas by using the scale constant. Thereafter magnetic intensity values are corrected by temperature, diurnal changes and normal corrections. So we will go one by one. What are the temperature corrections are there? Temperature corrections are changes in temperature affect the magnet system. But practically all modern magnetometers contain temperature compensated system. And so corrections are seldom applied for temperature variations normally prevailing in the field condition. For it may be necessary to apply this correction hardly 1 gamma per degree centigrade. So this is the temperature correction. Then next one, that is the correction of diurnal variations. In diurnal variation, the changes in the magnetic field are related to the rotation of the earth. The changes are greater and more irregular during the day than at night. The changes may range from few gammas to 100 gammas or more. Also, continuous reading of the changes in diurnal variations may obtain using magnetic reduction or recording instruments. If that is not available, the field magnetometer may use to read the variations by repeating the observation over a base station. So when we see the magnetic base, it is in India, that is the, it is in Dehradun. So the repeat, we have to take readings over the base station by establishing in that particular area. So if there are magnetic storms, the variations may be large and highly fluctuating. On such rare occasions, it may become necessary to suspend the field work. So, on the basis of this, we can plotted the noting the observed values against respective times. So, in this way, we have to do corrections of diurnal variations. Then next, that is the normal corrections. In normal correction, there is a normal variation of magnetic intensities with the changes in latitude and longitude. When we go equator to pole, the automatically magnetic readings are changes. The total intensity of the earth field at the northern magnetic pole is about plus 63,500 gammas. While at the southern magnetic pole, it is about 70,000 gammas. The intensity at the magnetic equator is about 39,000 between the magnetic poles and the equator, but the variation cannot be calculated as a function of latitude. Since the rate of change is not regular, in general the total field intensity, that is called a T, is the vertical component Z, both which are minimum at the magnetic equator. So by increasing the latitude, the horizontal component H is maximum at the magnetic equator. And diminishes with increase of latitude. The correction for variations may be 8 to 10 gammas per kilometer. In some latitudes where the longitude corrections are usually quite small, about 2 gamma per kilometer, and it may be neglected. So these are called a normal corrections. The next aspect, that is the preparation of magnetic anomaly maps and profiles. So whenever we are going to preparing a magnetic anomaly maps, so there should be, after necessary corrections have been applied, once we have done corrections, temperature correction, diurnal variation correction, normal corrections, then we have to make a necessary correction, and the reduced data values, gammas, are plotted on the map showing the station locations and contour lines. So are drawn by joining the points of the equal magnetic intensity at suitable intervals. In mining field exploration, the anomalies are large magnitude and the contour intervals may be 50 to 100 gamma or more. In oil field exploration, where the anomalies are weak, contour intervals at 10 to 20 gamma may be necessary. So further profiles along certain lines may also be plotted showing the variations of magnetic intensity. The anomaly maps and sections so obtained will form the basis for interpreting the data in terms of subsurface geology. So on the basis of that, we can prepare a magnetic anomaly map. Then next aspect, that is the removing regional effects in magnetic anomaly maps. So there are three methods, that is, one is the graphical method, second one is the Griffin's method, and third one is the second vertical derivative method. So In the preparation of magnetic anomaly maps from data obtained in ground, magnetic surveys have already been explained. So therefore, before magnetic anomaly maps, so we should have some regional effects, and that can be regional effects is removed by the graphical method. In graphical method, so we have to In graphical method, by plotting profiles of the observed field data, the regional gradient in each of the profiles may be drawn approximately by inspection. And the trend indicated by dotted line, that is profile, we can say that AB, the residual anomaly which deviates or disturbs the regional gradient will then be evident. This residual can be plotted separately by a series of profiles. So in other cases, so that is called as graphical method. Then second method, that is the Griffin's method. In Griffin's method, it is named after W.R. Griffin in 1949, who proposed it's originally for obtaining a residual gravity. It is equally applicable to the magnetic data. The method is based on average the magnetic intensity values of the various points around the circumference of circle with the center of at a station about which the residual is to be obtained. So the average of these values at the points 1, 2, 3, 4 are taken on the basis of this Griffin's method is generally used. Then last method, that is the second vertical derivative method. So this method was first used by Elkins in 1951 for gravity data, and it is applicable for the magnetic data also. So the unit used for the expressing the second derivative is gamma per kilometer per kilometer. So on the basis of these three methods, we can determine the regional effects in magnetic anomaly maps. So next one, that is the interpretation. When we go interpretation, there are two types of interpretation. One is the qualitative interpretation and second one is the quantitative interpretation. In qualitative interpretation, the magnetic anomalies yields information on the general aspect of the bodies causing the anomalies in the area, such as strike, strain, trends of that particular deposit or over deposit, faults, etc. In quantitative methods, the interpretation deal with the individual anomalies and deduce the shape, size, depth of the causative bodies. The quantitative methods of interpretation may be divided into four groups, that is the half anomaly width relation, matching field curves with theoretical calculated anomaly curves, Peters slope method, the downward continuous method. These methods involve the different procedure but are all essentially governed by the theory of distribution of magnetic potentials. So this is nothing but the interpretation. Then next one, that is the applications of this magnetic field surveying. Generally, this magnetic field surveying is useful for to search iron ore deposits. If any non-magnetic area having magnetic deposit, particularly iron ore or magnetite is there, then on the basis of that magnetic surveying, we can identify iron ore deposit in that particular area. Second applications of this magnetic surveying, that is the to identify structures. If we are going from any area, so we have to see what are the different structures which are present in that particular area. So maybe fault is there, fold is there, and these type of structures, by doing a magnetic survey, we can identify what type of surveys are there, what type of trend is of that particular structures. So that can be identified on the basis of this structure, on the basis of that particular magnetic reading. Then third application of this magnetic surveying, that is the to search petroleum products for the to search or to identify petroleum exploration or petroleum deposit in beneath the crust. So this method is useful to search petroleum products also. Then last, that is the engineering investigations. If we have
doing or construct a dam, bridge or anything others. So by doing this magnetic survey, we can identify what type of rock is there, foundation rock is there. So these are the different applications of this.
In this lesson, we have discussed field procedure of magnetic method surveying. Then second aspect we have seen, that is the reduction of data. Then removing of regional effects from the magnetic anomaly map. Then that is the interpretation, and last part, that is the what are the different applications of this magnetic method. So this part we have seen in this lesson. If you like my video, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Geo Entire, all about the earth.